are the most sacred resources for the future development of our nation, Nigeria. That's why a program like TripLearn is so important for young ones, in which they get to learn new skills. With this, I welcome you to this week's edition of TripLearn. Our destination is the Arts Department of Baptist Boys High School, Okechaje, Abeokuta, where we'll be taught how to make fingerprints and turn them into beautiful artworks. Come along with my friends and I.
And today on the program, what is what we will be doing? This is flowers from different shades of color, from candles. We use candles to make. And these are fingerprints. These are fingerprints made into flowers. Do you like this?
Yeah.
And this is water bottle and some other things for at home. So we got them to make it at home to complement the flowers. Do you understand that? So on the program today, this is what we are doing. My name is Olusegun Adeniyi, and here with me is Dari to be coming with me. So let's move over there and start to work.
Children, you are welcome once again. These are the materials we work with. Here we have cardboard. What do I call it?
Cardboard.
This is cardboard. And here we have straw. What do you use straw for?
To drink.
But today we'll be using it for artwork. And here we have 49. These are 49. And we have colors. These are poster colors. And over here we have palette knives. Palette what?
Knives.
Palette knives. And we have pure water sachets. I hope you can identify this.
Yes.
These are pure water sachets. And we have stones. You pick that from outside. Stones. And here we have a post-it. This is a post-it. It's also a gum, and we have empty bottles of drinks, soft drinks, and we have of the wine. These are wine bottles. These are part of what we'll be using today. And here we have glue. This is glue, and we'll be using glue for this. We use the glue to make this colorful paint. Do you understand that?
Yes.
And I will tell you how to do that. So children, apart from this material I've shown you, we also have palette here, palette for mixing colors, and we have water. The water you use that to wash your hands when we are done. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, we are going to start with fingerprints. I know you must have done this in your primary school days, but now we want to do something unique. Let me have your hand. And you can do the same thing over there. Now we can add the same. Now we take it outside to dry, and you go outside also to wash your hands. Can we just do that now? Now that the works are dry, we are now going to cut. Let's cut them out. You use what? What did I call it earlier? 49. These are 49. So you use them. And when you are cutting, you cut along the boundary. You don't just cut at the tip of, at the edge of that piece. You understand that? You create some boundaries of. As you can see, so this is what you are looking for. So you cut it out, you leave some boundaries. Okay, can you just leave this camera? That is one of the fingers. So you cut a lot of that fingerprint. You can see different colors from what you have done today. Do you like them? So this is what we are going to put together to make a flower now. So let's do some cutting again. Okay, the next stage now is to cut out some lines. It's like a stripes. So that is what we want to cover. And to take the measurement, you can use half an inch. Half an inch on your ruler. Half what? An inch on your ruler. So how do you do that? You place your ruler on the cardboard and you mark out. When that is done, you place your ruler on both ends. Do you understand that? So that is when to have an accurate line. So you now rule. Is that clear? And when you are done, you now take another measurement. That is the length of the stripe. So what is the length you are going to use? You are going to use 4. So you mark out 4. And you mark out 4. You do the same thing. Mark it out. So when you are done with the ruling, it is now time to cut. It is now time to do what?
Cut.
I would like to get your responses. Is that time to do what?
Cut.
Okay, so you can see what I'm trying to cut now. So you cut like that, different colors. You cut, this is color what?
White.
This is white. This is white. This is what?
White.
Okay. So you cut, we have done with the white. You can cut more. It depends on the quantity of flowers you want to do. Now you see me, what you use for the center. So you cut that out as well. You use your compass. It depends on the length you want to do. I hope you can see it. Think that. I hope you can see it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are some other ones we have cut. You can cut what?
Different colors.
And we have. Do you enjoy this exercise?
Yes.
So now we can now move forward. Now we have four of the fingerprints. You need 4 of the fingerprints to make one flower. So this is how we are going to arrange them. Arrange them on one another this way. Can you do that? Can you do that over there? Yes. Can you do the same thing we have done here? So when this is done, you can now apply gum. You remove one of them. Listen, look at what I'm doing. You apply gum here. And gum it. You apply gum as well. On this. Is that clear? And you place it on it. And here, what you just do, you just will apply gum. Yeah. Is that taking? Have you done that? The next thing to do is to apply yellow. At the middle, that is our flower. Now we are not done yet. We are still. You turn it upside down. When that is done, you take swirl. You take the swirl. You use masking tape to put them together this way. When that is done, you put it at the middle. Is that clear, children?
Yes, sir.
So when you do that, use masking tape. You now use your masking tape to tack it down. Is that taking? Not too wide. You make it short. So that because you are still going to apply this. And so that when you apply this, it will cover the tape. You understand that? It will cover the tape off. You understand that? So now you apply. But this time around, you don't just apply it on that end alone. You also apply on the other end this way. You understand that? You know why you do that? You allow this to get dry. And why you do that is just so that by the time you place it on it, it will be permanent. Do you understand that? It will be what? You allow it for some time before you place it on it. Now we can now place it on it. So you can see it. This is a wonderful job. Clap for them again. Clap for them. Okay, you can have this now and start the second one. Now that you are applied gum, that is a post-it on the paper, at the end, at the tip of the paper. Now we want to do the second design. So what you just do, you just choose one color. Now we are choosing blue. You place it. Yeah, why I asked you to apply it earlier, you allow it to dry. Because when the plastic is dry, that is when it can work better. When you do that, you can see that it's already gone. You can't remove it again. It's because you allow some time for it to dry. You understand that? And you start, you place another one, you leave space. You allow these edges, two edges to touch one another like this. Do you understand that? So you pick another one. The last one. That is one color. We are done with the first color. Now you take white. I'm working with two colors here. You do the same thing. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
You do what? You do the same thing. So I'm done with the second one. So you have two colors now. The next stage is to put them together. What did I say?
Put them together.
You put them together. How do you do that? You don't work at this edge. These are the outer part. This will be the inner. The place you join them, that will be your inner. And when you want to do the gummy, you have the what is it again?
Straw.
The straw, and you need the tape. You just bind them together this way. Why we are using two is just to strengthen the straw. You know the straw is very flexible.
Yes, sir.
So you just to strengthen it. Now you place it at the middle. Is that taking?
Yes, sir.
When you place it that way, you just cut a little masking tape again to tack it down. Is that taking?
Yes, sir.
And when that is done, you apply gum at the edges. Is that taking? And on top of the masking tape. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
And on the second one too, it's just to strengthen the acoustic. By the time I put them together, it will be fine. It will be what? It will be friends. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Now, and when you want to join them together, you don't just place it on each other like this. But you change it in such a way that it will create a kind of effect, interwoven effect. You understand that?
Yes,
one after another. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Look at it. Then you raise it up. That is how to do the second. You like it?
Yes.
Okay, let me see what you are doing over there. Wow, that is a wonderful work. You guys are doing wonderful work there. Okay, the last thing to do here is to apply. Like this one now, it's too long at this edge. You just cut it. You always cut the one that is very close to the floor. And you apply gum again. Yes, that is what I asked you to do. That is a wonderful work. Well done. Can you clap for them? You can raise it up, please. Okay, now, the last stage for this flower, for this particular design, is to apply gum. When you apply gum, you also apply gum on the sword too. Is that clear? So you apply gum on the sword and you allow it to dry for a while. When that is done, you place it. That is what we give it, that leaf effect. Do you like it?
Yes, sir.
Does it look like a flower?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is a wonderful flower. We are done with it. Can you just clap for me, please? And that is now we are now going to make the path. You know, this is a flower. A flower should have a path. And this is an example of what we are going to place now. You can see when you place it on it, it can now stand on its own. So how do we do this? Let's see. So children, it's now time to create the vase. So the first thing you do is to take your glue. It's different from the other gum we use, right?
Yes, sir.
This is also gum, but this is glue. So you cover it up and you add color. You add what?
Color.
What kind of color?
Red.
What kind of medium is that color? Like, it's like what?
Strawberry.
But this is not strawberry, please. What you do is to put the... You open up your sachet like this. Your pure water sachet. I hope you can identify this as pure water sachet, right? And you put it inside. So when that is done, you do that gently. And when that is done, the next thing is to tighten the edge. This particular edge. And what do you use again? You use masking tape. You use what?
Masking tape.
Yes. So right now, it is ready for use. And that is how I make all these ones. And that is how I made wood. All these other ones. And we have different colors there. And this is color red, like pink. This is pink. You use red to make the pink. It's because the red is not much. Do you understand that? So your pure water sachet, instead of throwing them away, you can also use it as an artwork. Do you understand that? This is part of recycling. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
This is part of recycling and it is useful. And you can see when you take your soft drinks or your bottle waters, instead of throwing the bottles away, you can use it for artwork. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
You can
sir.
Use it. I hope you can identify this as bottles.
Yes, sir.
I don't want to mention names, but this is one of the sorting. And these are wines. Also wines, you can use wine. These are wine bottles. These are what?
Wine
bottles. You can also use them. You see how we are going to use them now. So, but for the bottle, the plastic bottle, you just got it. It is very important that the edges are smooth. But when you notice that it is not smooth enough, you can bend it again like this and cut. Is that taking?
Yes, sir.
You have to have that perfect circle. And when that is done, you place it on. You remove the cover, please. You don't need the cover. You remove the cover. This is floorboard, and you can see that it's thicker than the normal cardboard. We have another one called seaboard, but this is stronger. You can cut the floorboard into any shape. And by the time you place it on it and you apply the gum, by the time you now put your flour, this is the flour. By the time you now place it on it, the weight of this flour can make it turn. You understand that?
Yeah.
But to strengthen it, to create a kind of reinforcement, what you do is stone. You apply stone. These are stones that are picked on the street. You just pick these stones. And before you do the gummy, you put it inside and you place it. By the time you carry it out, you can see that it has increased the weight. You understand that?
Yes.
So that is usually why we are applying the stones. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
And to apply the colors you have put into the sachet, you cut the edge. You understand that?
Yes.
For you to apply it, you cut the edge. I've done that. You cut the edge and you apply it. I can even write OGTV here. This is for O G T V. That is the design for OGTV. And when you have done that, you can now insert your flour. But you allow it to dry. It's just for the purpose of this program. That is why I'm inserting it now. You understand that? So can we now get more of it to have made? And we put our flour inside them. Can we get it? Okay. And again, we can also write. What program are we on?
Tripling.
Okay. We can also write two planes hitting OGTV with the color. This is OGTV. And now let's see what he's doing over there. He's doing a wonderful job there too. That is a wonderful one. And now we are going to write two planes. What did I call it?
Tripling.
And I told you earlier on that when you want to walk, you cut the tip. And that's what I want to do right now. When you cut it, and now you can now use it. What do you call it?
Tripling.
Can you spell it out for me?
T.
Yes?
I-P.
P. Are you sure?
Yes.
Yeah, good. And
L-E-A.
N. Can you just pronounce it?
Triple.
Triple what?
Triple.
So now put your flowers. You can put the hands now, dip it inside the bottle. You can see that even your wine bottles are useful. Do you enjoy that?
Yes, sir.
Children, do you enjoy that?
Yes, sir.
We can now move them over there to showcase them.
Friends, let's say thank you to Uncle.
Thank you, Uncle.
You are welcome. Bye.
Bye.
Hope you enjoyed this week's edition of Two Plain on OGTV and also found it quite interesting and educative. Do join us same time next week for another edition of Two Plain, same station, OGTV. Goodbye and God bless.
Bye.